Welcome in the quick tutorial. I want to show you how to create more cinematic feel for your shot. We're going to use DOF, which is depth of the field. I downloaded assets directly from the FAB, so I have environment and also I have character. As well, I created the cinematic sequence. If you don't know how to create sequence or cameras, you can click the link above. We have the full video about this specific topic. So when you create the sequence, you will have the option to create the camera. It's called Cine Camera Actor from Cinematic. And here you will notice two main functions, which is current aperture and focal length, just like in a real life. On the right side, in the details panel, when you scroll down, you will have the Filmback option. Here you can select the type of your camera. So right now we have digital film, and I'm going to change it to DSLR, which is like full frame camera. You will notice change in our viewport because we have our preview of our Cine camera lock, so you can see it in the real time. And when you scroll down in the details, you will see current focal length and the aperture. You can keyframe both of these values directly from the details tab. So for example, I can control it here, or I can control it as well inside the sequencer on the left side. As you can see, if I increase the focal length, also the blur or the depth of the field will increase. That's normal and natural reaction, just like in the real life. So let's try maybe something like 80 millimeters. We can keyframe it. Okay. Now I'm going to set up camera in the right position and I will keyframe it as well. And now we need to set up focus for our shot. So you will notice the option for manual focus. We can work with the manual focus for this example. So that's actually a very quick tip. If you click that picker and select, for example, object like this character in the shop, it's not going to work always the correct way because it also depends where is the pivot of the object. If it will be just a static object, probably everything will be fine. But because we have animation of this character, when I increase the size of the viewport, you will notice with that scalability, even high scalability, you will notice that focus is not in the correct place. And in the details panel, you have option in the focus settings, draw debug focus plane. When you select that and you change the values, you will see the debug plane, right? It will help you set up focus in the perfect position. Okay, now I can keyframe it. Let's just increase the size of the viewport. And as you can see, it looks okay as well because I have 80 millimeters camera. We have depth of the field behind our character. And if I change it to cinematic quality, we can actually have the preview of the final shot. So this is how it's going to look when you start to render your shot. And now also I can work with the current aperture. So higher the values for aperture, the more sharper the area in your shot. Lower the values actually has the opposite effect. So if I go very high, like something like maybe 20, and you take a look, everything basically in our shot will be in the focus. So if you want to get more cinematic feeling, obviously you will work with the higher focal length and the lower aperture, right? So let's just keyframe it for now. We can set up for 2. Okay, but what if you want to have depth of the field and as well you want to work with the wider camera, which means you need to decrease the current focal length. So let's try for this example maybe 24 millimeters. So now when I change the position of my camera, I'm going to keyframe it. As well, we need to change the focus. Again, I'm going to select Draw Debug Focus Plane. Something like that should work perfect. It automatically keyframed. And as you can see, we have some depth of the field, but this is very subtle. So how can we increase it even more? So the only option right now, obviously, it will be to work with the current aperture. If you try to change it inside the sequence to something maybe like 0.5 and you keyframe, you will notice
it's not going to work.
You will get 1.2 value. So how we can change it? In the detail panel on the right side, you will have the lens settings. And here you will notice the minimum aperture for this lens. And as well, you will notice the maximum aperture for this lens. So let's try maybe the settings 0.5. Okay, and now everything is working. So just like that, you can create more cinematic feeling for your shot by controlling the aperture and the focal length in your shot and customize the lens settings. I hope you like this tutorial. And I see you in the next one.